Living Waters Church, the Church of the Languages. Pastor Louise Forche, www.livingwatersofelgin.org. English, Glory. Spanish, Gloria. Polish, Słowa. Swahili, Utukufu. English, The Lord, The Lord, The Lord. French, Loue, Loue, Loue. English, a man saved for a purpose. Moses. Moses' life is really divided into three major parts. His first 40 years of life, he lived in Egypt. His second 40 years of life, he lived in Media. His last 40 years of life, he lived in the wilderness. His parents' name was Jochebed and Amram. But Jochebed is also Moses' great aunt because Amram married his father's sisters. Moses' siblings was Aaron and Miriam. Well, during the time that Moses was born, the king was having a problem with the Israelites. He felt like they were having too many children. So what he did, he ordered all male babies to be thrown in the Nile River. Well, when Jochebed had her baby, she hid it for 3 months. And when she couldn't hide it anymore, she made a basket and she put the baby in the basket. She told her daughter, Marion, to watch where the basket would go. The king's daughter saw the basket, took the basket out of the Nile River, adopted the baby, called the baby Moses, drawn from the river. See, God saved Moses for a purpose. He saved Moses twice as a baby. Once from the king and the other from the Nile River, the crocodiles. See, during Moses' time, the Nile River was full of crocodiles. And the crocodiles is the largest reptile there is. They're about 20 feet long. So God saved Moses for a purpose. Moses lived in Egypt for 40 years. When he became an adult, he learned that the king's daughter was not his mother. He learned that his mother was a Hebrew slave. So one day, he looked out and he saw a taskmaster beating a Hebrew slave. Moses looked around to see if he saw anyone, and Moses killed the taskmaster and he hit him. But the thing is, the king found out about it. And when the king found out about it, Moses became afraid and he ran for his life. He ran to Midian, where he spent his next 40 years. Which Midian is mostly in the northwest of Arabia, the desert between Egypt and Canaan. Moses became a shepherd and a son-in-law to Jethro, a Midianite priest. Jethro gave his daughter Zipporah to Moses in marriage, Exodus 2:21. Moses and his wife Zipporah had two sons, Gershom, which means from a strange land, and Eleazar. Exodus 18, verses 3 and 4. Moses learned patience because, see, he was a shepherd and the sheep are stubborn. God was preparing him for his purpose because, see, the Israelites were very stubborn people. Near the end of his 40 years in Midian, which made him 80 years old, Moses experienced a dramatic calling to ministry. He was given an assignment by God, and when God said, "Take off your shoes, this is holy ground," the assignment was given at the burning bush in the wilderness near Mount Sinai. God had saw his people suffer, and he wanted Moses to go tell the Pharaoh to let my people go. Tell him, "I am who I am has sent you." Exodus 4:3. Moses had a speech problem. Moses was just like some of us. Moses experienced low self-esteem due to his speech problem. Moses didn't feel secure in doing the job. Moses wanted God to get someone else. Moses was just like some of us. "Me, Lord, me, Lord, not me, Lord, me, Lord." Moses had a lot of excuses, just like some of us. God told him to take your brother Aaron with you. God demonstrated some of his power at the burning bush, and Moses had Aaron stay up. Aaron was the mouthpiece for Moses, a man saved for a purpose. Moses went before the Pharaoh, and he told the Pharaoh, "God said, let my people go." Moses did as Moses did as God requested. He took Aaron's staff and he turned it into a serpent. But the Pharaoh refused to let the people go. See, Aaron's staff represent the miracles before the Pharaoh. Exodus 4:24. Then there was 10 plagues. The Nile River turned to blood, and the fish died, and the river stank. The frogs came from the river and covered the land. Exodus 7:8. Gnats were plentiful over the land. The Pharaoh still refused. The flies covered the land. The boils broke out on everyone except the Israelite. The hail storm killed all the servants and the animals that was left out. All the livestock died. Then the locusts ate up everything that the hail left behind. Exodus 8:9-10. The Pharaoh still refused. Why did the Pharaoh refuse? Because the Hebrew slaves represented labor. If he let the Israelite go, who would do all that work? Darkness covered the land for 3 days. Lastly, the death of all firstborn sons of Egypt died, even the animals. The king's son died as well. Exodus 10:11. The Pharaoh called for Moses and he told him, "Take their things and leave." Moses and the Israelites gathered their things and left. In the meantime, the Pharaoh changed his mind. As they were traveling out of Egypt, they looked up and they saw the Egyptian and their chariots. Then they saw the Red Sea, which is between Egypt and Arabia. The Israelites panicked because they thought they had no way out. They didn't think they had an escape out. But see, God always give us an escape out. But we got to take the escape out. Moses said, "Fear ye not. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. The Egyptians whom ye have seen today, ye shall see no more." The Lord allowed the blowing wind to pull back the sea and divide the sea. According to history, the sea is 3,000 feet deep. The Israelites went across the Red Sea and the Egyptians followed, but all of them drowned in the Red Sea. See, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Maybe you have a Red Sea. Maybe your Red Sea is grief today. You are experiencing some griefs, some shock, some denial. This really isn't happening to you. Anger. Why this is happening to me? Guilt. If I had known, there's such thing as true guilt and false guilt. True guilt helps us to put our priorities in order. And after we put our priorities in order, taking responsibility for what we did, then we need to let the guilt go. Because when we don't let the guilt go, we become where it occupies our mind. And Satan loves to play with our mind and have negative thoughts running through our mind. So once you put your priorities together, let go of the guilt and the false guilt. Don't blame yourself for something you didn't do. If you didn't do it, don't blame yourself. Depression, why bother? Things will never be the same. Loneliness, I can't make it on my own. Expression of the thing that you need to do is just express your feelings out loud. Ask for help. Accept the help. Be kind to yourself. Get plenty of rest. Know that God ministers to you through His comforting presence. Know that God ministers to you through His word. God uses grief for good, for your good. A time of grief, God can lead you to confession. God can lead you to repentance. God can lead you to restore your relationship with God. So stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Salvation simply means deliverance from the power of sin. Redemption. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. In the Old Testament, salvation sometimes referred to deliverance from danger, deliverance of the weak from the oppressed, the healing of the sick. It also refers to the national deliverance from military threat, which is the Red Sea, Exodus 14:13. So stand still and see the power of the Lord.